But out of all this, what was your story with ISEC, and what platform did you decide to take on?
I think my focus was much more local in a way. I was very much inspired by the slogan of thinking global and acting local. I was trying to push ISEC in Egypt towards more of local community development, more of Egyptians understanding their own culture before becoming better communicators with other cultures. I feel for you to be able to communicate with other cultures and have this cross-cultural understanding, you have to have a strong identity and pride and understanding, not arrogance and not fascism or anything, but just real understanding and respect for your own values, your own culture before you start communicating. So this was always my belief that this is the role of ISEC is to prong. One is to really focus on your educating your people about their culture and about their potential and their skills and their community and so on. And the other side is to start to build bridges with other cultures. Yeah. So most of my time was in ISEC Egypt was spent on that, and trying to promote maybe some community development aspects of our work, but also attending the international conferences was always very inspiring for me. I was very lucky to have attended two ICs, one in Spain, 94 and 95 in Sri Lanka, and the IPM in Malta, and at that time it was the AFCO, the African Congress, in Kenya and in Tunisia. So it was a very rewarding experience in that sense. Yeah. In addition, of course, to some of the international workshops that we had here, the International Trainers Congress that we had in Fayed in the Red Sea, where we had many international delegates as well. So it's, I think it was this combination of international exposure, but also getting the energy and the inspiration from that to then focus on locally.
What do you value the most out of ISEC that's led you to the decisions you've made today?
I think definitely in ISEC you get exposed in general to a lot of ideas, a lot of potential. You learn more about yourself and about others, how to deal with others, communication skills, team, how to work in a team, leadership skills, all these that are very important for your career and for anything that you do in life. Yeah. I think in ISEC it's like a factory, and it's like an incubator for people that where you develop these skills, and you really look at people who enter ISEC, especially out of other student activities that you see, and others who haven't had this privilege or were not lucky to go through this process, and you see a big difference in the confidence and the self-esteem and the ability to communicate with different sectors of society, the corporate sector, and so on. So I think this is definitely one big part of it, and I think the other part is this idea of also, I think this is a very important aspect in, and I pity countries, including Egypt in some cases, where students in public universities are not as privileged in having enough opportunities and openness in terms of their student body, student clubs and so on. Because I believe this is where you get to understand yourself, your potential, where you get empowered and so on. It's these 4 or 5 years of university.